So today we learn how to create a single link list and how to traverse or display the nodes of the single link list. So I think I'll cover these two topics in today's class. So but in a single link list, I'll cover all these topics. Insertion of node. You can insert a node at the beginning. You can insert the node at the end. You can insert the node at any position. Or you can insert the node after any value, after any element or value. Okay, so there are number of insertion operations. Similarly, there are number of deletion operations. Delete at begin, delete at end, delete at any position, delete after any value. Okay, or delete any value. Then you have to write a program how to merge two link lists. To sort an element from the single link list, to sort all the elements of the single link list. So by the array, already you know how to do the searching and sorting operation. So what here now by the single link list, you have to do all these kinds of operations, then reversing a single link list. So these are the different operations, possible operations that are applicable over the data structure, any kind of data structure, maybe single link list or double or circular link list. Okay. So last class, yesterday already I said, for creation of the single link list, you need a self-referential structure. Okay. So now tell me, what is self-referential structure? Saika Chaudhary? Okay. Pratik Chakra, are you there? Pratik Chakra, am I audible to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you audible?
Okay. So, Pratik Chakra, are you there? Actually, I'm asking the question, for the creating a single link list, you need a different types of structure. That structure is called as the self-referential structure. What is that? What do you mean by self-referential structure? Anyone?
What is self-referential structure? Is which has a pointer to itself.
One member of the structure is a pointer
that points to the structure. Same structure itself. It is called as the self-referential structure. Okay. So for creating the nodes, when you are going to design any kind of link list, so it is nothing but the collection of nodes. So these nodes are nothing but you have to create a structure for this node. Okay, so you have to create a structure for this node, and all these nodes are same type. All the nodes are, the structure is of same type. Then what is that structure? So you have to break every node into two part. One part is the information part. The other part is the address part. Okay, that means it is pointing to the next node in the linked list. It is pointing that address is nothing but the, it is the address of the next node in the linked list. Okay, so here I am taking that information part is of type integer. You can put of any kind of information. Okay, that means in this information part, you can write the student details also. That means student details is also another structure. Okay, so here you can write struct student. It is also okay. So another part is the next part, or it is nothing but the address part. So before going to that is the details of creating a single link list or to traverse a single link list. First, let us clear, all of you clear, how to write a program by using a structure. Okay, so I'll share my screen that DevC compiler. So is it visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now this is a very simple structure. This is a very simple structure. So this structure I create, its name is point. That means basically this is the structure for a point in the 2D two-dimensional structure. So every point has x coordinate, every point has y coordinate. So I take this x and y coordinate are of type integer type. So this is the declaration of the structure. So for that you need the struct keyword. Struct keyword is used to declare a structure. struct, the name of the structure is point. Okay, again, this is your revision part. Already you know this part in your C programming. But for the linked list, again, you need the structure to create the nodes of a structure. Create the nodes, you need a structure. So here two parts, X and Y part, right? So now I create the variables of this point type. Okay, now structure, this point is the user defined data type. It is user defined data type. Okay, so it is not the built-in data type, it is the user defined data type. So as it is the user defined data type, you have to create the variables of this data type. Okay, I create here three variables of this data type. That means I create three points, P1, P2, P3. I create three points. So every point having two dimensions, that is X and Y coordinate. So now we can say, when you declare a structure, that means at this point, memory is allocated, or at this point, memory is allocated. So when you declare the template or blueprint of a point, at this point, memory is allocated by the compiler, or when the variable is declared, at that time, memory is allocated.
After declaration of the variable, only the memory is allocated.
After declaration of the variable, only the memory is allocated. So this is, that means in this case here, memory is not allocated. That's why you are not writing X equal to 2, Y equal to 3. Like this type of declaration is not possible. If you have to give some value for the structure member by the dot operator, okay? To access the members of the structure, you need dot operator. You need dot operator or arrow operator. Okay, so dot operator is basically, this is the static allocation. For dynamic allocation, you need the arrow operator. So here you see, how can I access the members of the point? So I take one point, that is P1. For this point P1, I have two coordinates. Then how can I give the value? So P1 is a variable. So for this point, I have two members, X coordinate, Y coordinate, okay? Okay, so for every point you have two parts, one is the X coordinate, Y coordinate. Then how can I give this value for this variable X and Y? For that I need the dot operator, P1 dot X equal to 20, P1 dot Y equal to 5. So I give the value of this member X equal to 20, and the variable for Y, I give the value equal to 5. Okay, so now here you see, next is the printf statement for point P1, X equal to what, Y equal to what. For that, I display all the variables value by using P1 dot X, P1 dot Y. Okay, so what I get the output here, when I run this program, just I give declare a variable P1. I give the value of the members of P1, X equal to 20, Y equal to 5. So when I run this program, I get for point P1, X equal to 20, Y equal to 5 for this printf statement. Okay, so let's run this program. So here you see for point P1, X equal to 20, Y equal to 5. So what you see? For a given structure, to access the members of the structure, you need the dot operator. You need the dot operator. Okay. Then what are these? So these are the address. Okay. So when you have to declare three variables of a structure, I want to see what is the address of the first variable, what is the address of second variable, what is the address of third variable. So here I declare, first see the program. So address of P1, address of P1 equal to, I write address of P1. That address operator is used to see the address of a variable. Okay. Then what is percent U? What is percent U?
To display address.
Display, this is the unsigned integer. So this is the format specification for the unsigned integer, because address is always positive. Address is always positive. You can write percent U over here, no matter. But as it is unsigned, you can write percent U. Okay. So address of P1, address of P2, address of P3, these are the variables of point type. Okay. Suppose I have to see, because in the linked list, you need to know what is the address, what is the value at that address. Okay. So first, how to know the address? For that, you need the address of the variable. Write the address operator before the variable name. Now let's run this program. So here you see. So you can see here, address of P1 equal to, so because every structure member that point P1, two integer types are there, so it takes 8 bytes of memory. So here you see, this is the first address, this is the address of the first variable, this is the address of the second variable, this is the address of the third variable. Okay, so all these variables are taking 8 bytes of space. Right, all of you clear how to access the structure member by the dot operator? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So next, see. So this one. So this one, by simply by the dot operator, we are giving the value. So this is another program. Suppose you have to write sum of two complex numbers, by using structure. Okay. So for that, I declare the structure of type complex. It has two parts, real part and imaginary part. Okay. So here I can say, this is one way of declaring the structure variable. The other way is, you can write the structure variable here, C1, C2. So this is also the another way, other way of declaring the structure variable. Okay. So now I assign the real part of the first complex number. If this is the first complex number, I assign the real part equal to 2, imaginary part equal to 3. For the second complex number, I assign the real part equal to 3, imaginary part equal to 5. Okay. So what is the resultant complex number after adding? So you have to add C1.real plus C2.real, C1.imaginary plus C2.imaginary. Okay. So at that, after running this program, I get the output or the final complex number after addition is 5 plus %i, that means 8i. I get the output 5 plus 8i. Okay. So let's run this program. So the final complex number is 5 plus 8i. So this is the way by using structure with the dot operator, how can we access the structure member? Now the question is, so here I am directly assigning the members of the structure. If I have to give the input to the keyboard, then how can I write a program? Suppose I have to give the input through the keyboard, then how can I write a program? Bolo. If I have to give the input through the keyboard, just I have to use the scanner function. Scanner. So here the my member is int type, so %d, real part and imaginary part, 2%d, then ampersand c1.x, or what is that variable name? C1.real, ampersand c1.imaginary. Okay, let's see, first run this program. So it is asking that you have to input something. It's blinking means the user, that compiler is going to ask you to enter some value. Real part equal to 2, imaginary part equal to 3. Okay. So here the result is incorrect because the second complex number is not till now entered. Okay. So in this way, you can give the input by the ampersand operator, by the from the keyboard, or directly you can also initialize the variable simply by writing c1.real equal to something, c1.imaginary equal to something. Okay. So this is the normal way of by the static allocation, you can give the value of the variable for a structure member. Now see, the question is, if it is the dynamic allocation, because our linked list is that node is created dynamically, if then how can you allocate the memory dynamically? How can you assign the values for that memory location dynamically? Okay. Because I'm using the malloc function, so for that I need stdlib.h, standard library.h, where the malloc, alloc, all these functions that is defined in this header file. Okay, the same program I'm writing, but here the memory allocation is done at the compile time, so done at the runtime. Okay, not at the compile time. So you can see what is the meaning of this statement. Type yeah, is struct.
We have used comp in place of struct complex.
That means just I am renaming, or I am going to, if my structure having a very lengthy name, so I can also make it shortcut. Okay. So instead of, because you have seen every time for the declaration of the variable, struct keyword is used. Okay. Struct keyword is used. So to avoid that one, just by the type there, just you are redefining the data type, that syntax is, it is the keyword. Okay, by the type there, now the struct complex is renamed as COMP. Okay, that is the complex, COMP stands for complex. So it is the, you are going to make a very certain name, or you can redefine, just give some alternative name for the given data type. Type def keyword is used. So now, inside the main function, you see, I declare two pointers, C1 and C2. So this is the beginning of the single linked list. Be clear in how the memory is allocated, how to assign the values in that memory allocation, all these things. So two pointers, C1 and C2, because my program is to find the sum of two complex numbers. Okay. So I declare two pointers, C1 and C2 of which type? Complex type. Okay, that means these pointers, this is a pointer, jiska value kya hoga? Kuch ek address hai. That means this pointer is holding some address. That means suppose the address equal to 1000. That means in that 1000th address, if this location is 1000, okay, in this location is 1000, then what happen? You get a structure type. A structure type means it has two part. One part is the real part, another part is the imaginary part. Okay, that's why it is called as the, when you declare any pointer of that type. If I declare a pointer of integer type, then what happens? If I declare a pointer of integer type, let's see here, just I will explain. If I declare a pointer of integer type, suppose if I declare int star p or asterisk p, so what it implies? I declare a pointer p, okay? I declare a pointer p. P में क्या है, कुछ एड्रेस है, let the address equal to anything, any xyz. So that means now at that x1 location, what is present? Some integer value is present. At that x1 location, some integer value is present. Okay. If I write float star f, okay, then what it implies? Float star f, what it implies?
F pointer points to any float type of value.
Address of any location where some floating value, you can store only the floating value. Okay, it is the meaning of the declaration of the variable. But remember that pointer, what is the content? That pointer, the content is always an integer. Address is an integer. The content of pointer is always an integer. But it is going to the point to a location where the character type present, int type present, float type present. Any data type may be present, but the content of a pointer is always an integer. Okay. So next, coming back to the program. So now the question is how to allocate memory for that variable, pointer variable. Because the pointer is declared, now the time is to allocate memory by the malloc function. In C programming, you already know malloc function, calloc function, realloc. These are memory allocation functions that are used to memory allocation. Okay. So what is the syntax of malloc? The syntax of malloc is, so this is malloc. Okay. Then you have to inside the malloc. Basically, the syntax of malloc is void. Okay. But void means just you are creating the room for any variable. Which kind of variable? You have to do the typecasting. For which kind of variable in that newly created room you have to store, you have to do the typecasting. If I write int here, then what happens? In that room, I can store the integer type of data. If I write COMP, that is the complex, I have to create a room where I can store. That room is partitioned into two parts. One part is the that is real part. Another part is the imaginary part. That's why this typecasting is needed in the malloc function. Okay. So here, what is the syntax? The syntax is malloc size of complex. What is the size of complex here? So see the syntax of the structure of the complex. What is the size of complex? What is the size? So I have two integer part. The size of the every complex
eight
number.
Bytes.
Every complex number equal to 8 bytes.
8 bytes.
Size of every complex number equal to 8 bytes. One part is the integer, that is 4 bytes. Another part is the imaginary, that is also 4 bytes. Total 8 bytes is required for that node or for that element for the complex number. Now coming to here, the syntax is malloc size of complex. That means if this statement is successfully executed, that means in my computer's memory, so at a time 8 bytes is allocated. 8 bytes is allocated. Okay. So in this 8 bytes, 4 bytes for the real part, another 4 bytes for the imaginary part. Okay. 4 bytes for the real part, another 4 bytes for the imaginary part. And this part is required for the typecasting. Okay, this part is required for the typecasting because by default malloc function, it returns the void type. Okay, nothing. That is the blank memory space. So in that memory space, if you have to store the integer type, then you write int star. If you write a float star, then what happens? In that memory location, you can put the floating point value. If I write complex type, then I have to do the typecasting by this way. COMP for the complex type. Complex star malloc size of complex. Okay, so be clear in the notation. Every time when you write any complex, any linguist program, you have to do the malloc function by this way. So C1 equal to, you have to allocate memory for the first complex number. So this is for the first complex number. So the second one is for the second complex number. So all of you clear in the memory allocation? How to allocate the memory for a variable?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes? Okay. So now I go to the next line. So memory allocation is over. So you are going to allocate memory for the first complex number, for the second complex number, C1 and C2. Okay. If you write address of C1, address of C2, you can print, you can know in which address location C1 is present, in which address location C2 is present. Write two printf statements to know in which memory location C1 variable is present, in which memory location C2 variable is present. Okay. So now it's time to enter the value for that complex number. Okay. For every complex number, you have two parts. One is the real part, another one is the imaginary part. Real part, imaginary part. Okay. So now, so this is the pointer. So dot operator is not required. For that, you need the arrow operator. Okay, for a pointer to access the member, you need arrow operator. Enter the first complex number. Okay, so as my integer is the member is of type integer, so I need the format specification percent d. So here ampersand c1 arrow real. Okay, address c1 arrow real. What it means? Now you have to give the value for the real part. You have to give the value for the real part. For that, I need address of C1 arrow real. Address of C1 arrow real. Address of C1 arrow imaginary. Okay. So to give the input, to display the value, simply write C1 arrow real, C1 arrow imaginary. Okay. So this is for the input. Address operator is required. To display the value, simply write the variable name, arrow operator, the member name. Variable name, arrow operator, member name. Okay. So now you see. So enter the first complex number. So in this way, I can enter the first complex number, the real part and imaginary part of the first complex number. Enter the second complex number. In this way, I give the input for the second complex number. And what is the sum of two complex numbers? Similarly, I have to write C1 arrow real plus C2 arrow real, then C1 arrow imaginary plus C2 arrow imaginary. Okay, because it is the C1 and C2 are the pointers. By a pointer, I can access arrow real part, C1 arrow imaginary part. By the arrow operator, I can access the members of the structure by a pointer. If it is static allocation, by a normal variable, I write C1 dot real. This is the difference between static allocation and dynamic allocation. C1 dot imaginary. Okay. So all of you clear how to keep the input, how to first declare the memory for a variable and how to keep the input for the members of the variable. All of you clear?
Ma'am, why I is written in between the person D, ma'am?
Because this is in the printf statement, just to display like this, just to display 3 plus I4, just to display.
Okay.
That means first complex number is 2 plus 3i, sorry, I3 or 3i. So this is the representation of the complex number. Second complex number is suppose 1 plus I1. Then what is the resultant? 3 plus 4i. Okay, 3 plus 4i.
Okay.
Just to display that I is for to represent a complex number. Let's run this program. Enter the first complex number. That means I have to keep the real part and imaginary part. 2, 3. Enter the second complex number. 1, 2. The sum of two complex number is 3 plus I5. You see here. So this is the output. Okay, so this part you see, so that I is written here to display it is a complex number, 3 plus I5. So all of you clear in the structure part, how yes, the structure variable is declared and initialized at the compile time, and how the structure variable is declared and initialized by the dynamic or at the runtime. Okay, for runtime, arrow operator is used. For compile time, dot operator is used. For runtime, you have to allocate the memory for the malloc function. For runtime, sorry, compile time, just simply write c1.real equal to something, c2.real equal to something. Okay. So this one is for the creation of the single linked list. So in the creation of the single linked list, I'm going to use the self-referential structure. I'm going to use the self-referential structure. One part is the information part. Other part is the address part. Okay, so this is one way of declaring the structure member, structure variable. Stat is a pointer. Okay, so it is initialized to null because stat is a pointer that is not pointing to any node of the linked list. It is equal to null now. It represents nothing is present. There is still now no linked list is created. Next, so type def struct node equal to node. That means I just rename struct node to the new name. The new name is node. The new node is new name is node. So when I declare any variable of struct node type, okay, so this is the new data type. So I can also write node by using the pointer. I declare the pointer variable by the asterisk symbol. Okay, if I declare another member, simply I write node. Node is the new data type. I declare the variable, pointer variable of this node type. Okay, suppose I write ptr. If I write ptr, ptr is a pointer of this node type. That means it is pointing to a location. It is holding some address. In that address, what is present? A type of this node kind of data is present. That means it has two part. One part is the information part. Other part is the address part. So let's see. So here you have to allocate the memory for the node. How to allocate the memory? So already in the structure, that is the complex number you have seen. So first do the typecasting, because malloc function by default it returns void type. You have to do typecasting to allocate in that memory location what is the kind of data. Suppose in the college you are creating a room, a new building is constructed. So that is the malloc function. Okay. When you are writing, it is EE, it is CSE, it is ME. At that time, it is called as the typecasting. If it is CSC, then you have to write CSC star malloc, whatever the size of that building. Okay. So here I am going to allocate the room for the node type or complex type or point type. So this is memory allocation, or for that you have to do the typecasting and this much amount of byte. That means what is the size of the node? Now tell me what is the size of the node here? What is the size of node here? See, you have two part. One part is the information part. Other part is the address part. Then what is the size of this node? बताओ साइज क्या होगा?
8
बाइट. बिकॉज एड्रेस इज नथिंग बट दी हाँ एड्रेस इज नथिंग बट इंटीजर वैल्यू. ओके एड्रेस इज ऑल्सो एन इंटीजर वैल्यू. सो इंटीजर इज 4 बाइट एड्रेस इज ऑल्सो 4 बाइट टोटल इक्वल टू 8 बाइट. ओके सो फर्स्ट लेट्स सी दैट स्लाइड हाउ द नोड इज इंसर्टेड इन टू द सिंगल लिंक लिस्ट देन आई विल गो टू द प्रोग्राम. ओके so this is the algorithm, the same algorithm that is in the DevC compiler. Already you have seen the same algorithm I have written here. See how by the step by step node is created and the node is assigned to some value. So first one is the create single linked list. It is the function. Okay, it is the function to create a node for the single linked list. First statement. So this is the function to create a node for the single linked list. I declare two pointers. Node is the newly created node. So when I have to create the node, node is the pointer. Start is the pointer that is pointing to the first node of the linked list. Okay. Next line, node equal to node asterisk that is the type asterisk malloc size of node. Then what happens if this statement is successfully executed? Some memory is allocated for the node. Okay. And node that is the pointer. That pointer is pointing. Suppose x1 is the address. Whatever the value 21168, 21170, like anything, any address. Suppose I represent it by the value x1. Okay. So this is the address. The first node is stored. It is stored in the memory at x1 address. Next, you have to enter the data for the newly created node. Okay. Then I have to write the printf enter data, scanf, ampersand node information. Okay, already you have seen in the complex number how to give the input ampersand, that is CRO real, CRO imaginary. Here also you have to give the value for the information part by writing ampersand node info. Okay, node is the pointer already the newly created node. Node is the pointer that is pointing to the newly created node. So this is holding the address of the newly created node. Okay, and you have to give the information part of the new node by writing like this statement: address of node info. Node info. This is the information part. Okay, this is the information part. I have to write node info. That means I give the value at this information part. So here I am giving the value 18 to this information part. So next statement is, suppose you have to, it is first node is created. Okay, if this first node is created, if I write no over here, if I write no over here, then this part is not executed. This part is completely skipped. Then I get what? Node of next equal to node. This part equal to node, and my list is going to contain only single node in the single linked list. Okay. If I press N over here, if I press Y over here, then what happens? This while loop is continued until I press Y. Okay. If I press no, then this part is not executed. Then I have to go to the last part of the this function create single linked list. Let's see. So do you want to? Okay. So here you write if yes, Y is selected. Do you want more? If I select Y, so this Y is selected by the function getCSG function. C equal to getCSG. So now CSG is not equal to N or capital N or small N. You have to allocate memory for the second. You have to allocate for the second node. Okay, so this function, you allocate the memory for the second node. This address, whatever the address written by the malloc function, it is assigned to the malloc function is returning some address. So this is assigned to the node of next part. Okay, let the address equal to x2. So this x2 is assigned to the address of the first node. This x2 is assigned to the address of the first node. After that, node equal to node next. So here you can see first, if I till now, if I don't press N, that means if I press Y always, then what happens? This while loop is continued. So this while loop is continued. That means you have to create the second node, or you are going to create the second node. Now the node pointer is pointing to the second node. By enter data and ampersand node information, you have to give the value. You can see here 56 is entered for the information part. Again, it is the option, do you want more? Okay, if you press yes, that means this while loop is executed once more. If you press Y, next the while loop is executed, all the statements inside the while loop is executed. Okay, so now the memory is allocated for the third node. Node pointer is pointing to the third node. The address equal to x3. For the newly created node, let address equal to x3. So you have to put the address of x3. You have to put the address of x3. See here, put the address of x3. This is my address x3. So it is stored in the next part of the second node. It is stored in the next part of the second node, right? Then what is the next part of the third node? Next part of the third node, it depends on whether you are pressing Y or N. If you press Y, the next part of the third node is the address of the fourth node. Okay. If you press no, the address of the third node, the next part of the third node is null. Okay. So now do you want to insert more element? If I press Y again, okay. So again, this loop is satisfied. It is not equal to N. A new node is created. Okay. Memory is allocated for the fourth node. The node pointer is pointing to the fourth node. Then you can give the information part. Let it the information equal to 45. If I press, do you want two more node? Suppose I press N. No. No means, okay, so this condition is not satisfied. While loop, this condition is that is not satisfied, is equal to N, but it is not, the condition is not equal to N. As it is equal to N, this part is not executed. Then what is the next part? Node, the next part of the node is equal to null. The next part of the node is equal to null. Okay. Next part of the node equal to null.
That while loop condition.
That while loop condition.
While ch is not equal to n and ch is not equal to capital N. What does it mean? We will enter only one character.
Only one character. Only one character. You may press capital N or you may press small n. Okay. If you press Y or any other character other than N. Okay. If you press, because specifically I'm going to write the option whether you have to press Y or N. Okay. You may press capital Y or small y. Okay. If it is press Y, but it is not small n and capital N. Okay. That means now if I press Y or small y, then what happened? It is not equal to N. It is also not equal to capital N. Right? That means,
I have to enter both small n and capital
N. Anyone tell me the question?
Instead of and, shouldn't it be or? Yes, small n or capital N?
Or. That means by two bars, you are saying.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, anyone
yes.
is true. That means if you press, anyone is true. Okay. If I press capital, that is or and, so it also works. It's fine also. Okay. because it does not matter whether you're writing or and n. That means when you press capital N, basically we are writing what? Either small n or capital N. Okay, if anyone is true. Okay, you can write or over here, no matter. Okay. Right. So what is your question? Why all of you clear why I'm writing yes. here in the while loop the condition is this one? Okay. All of you clear or again I'll explain this algorithm how to create the nodes of the single linked list. Any doubt?
No, okay. ma'am.
One more, Chita. No, ma'am. Let's run this program. Clear? So first you see, first you have to declare the pointer. Okay, stat is the pointer that points to the first node and node is the pointer that points to the newly created node. Okay, so now you have to allocate memory for the newly created node. So for that malloc function is used. And you have to allocate memory, how much bytes of memory, it depends on the size of the node. Okay. So basically in our structure, the size of the node equal to 8 bytes. So it allocates 8 bytes of memory. And in that 8 byte, 4 byte is for the information part, 4 byte is for the address part. Okay. So first that means stat equal to node. That means stat is a pointer that points to the first node of the linked list. So memory is allocated if the statement is successfully executed. Memory is allocated, then you have to enter the information part for that node. Enter the information part, enter the data. So for that, you need the ampersand that address operator is used, node arrow info. Arrow operator is used because it's a pointer. As it is pointer to access the members of the structure, arrow operator is used. Okay. Next statement is, do you want to insert more element in the linked list? If it is yes, maybe it is yes or no. Okay. That getCSG function is going to accept the, that is going to read the characters from the keyboard and it is E for echo, okay? And this while loop is continued until you press no, okay? If it is no, this part is skipped by the compiler. After that, you have to write node of next equal to null. If I press no over here, for example, for the first time, if I press no over here, then this part equal to null, okay? Now, if I press Y here in my that is implementation of this PPT, already I have created 4 different nodes. So this loop is executed 3 times because already for the before the while loop I have created created one node. So this loop is executed 3 times. So finally, for the last node, I press no. My choice equal to no. So node of next equal to null. Node of next equal to null. Okay, so this is the way you are going to create the node of the linked list. So let's run this program. So same algorithm I'm writing here. So in this case, I just write 2 algorithms, one to create a linked list, another one to display the single linked list. Okay, so for creation of the single linked list, same code I'm writing here. Suppose you are saying it is the OR operator. Okay. So what is display of the single linked list? For displaying the single linked list, for example, I have 2 nodes. Stat is a pointer that points to the first node. Okay. So now you have to use the for loop. Okay. If stat equal to null, not of stat means if stat having some value. If stat having some value, okay, not of stat means it is equal to null. That means it is null value. That means my list is empty. Empty list, try again. Else, the single linked list elements are, you have to use the for loop. You have to take a pointer p, p equal to stat. That means this pointer is pointing to the first node and check whether p is equal to null or p is not equal to null. If some nodes are present in the list, p is not equal to null, then you have to display the p info. Suppose information part equal to 10, so it is going to display 10. Then p equal to p of next. Okay, next class I'll display again execute this display statement. So for this to for the completion, I'm explaining here. So p equal to p of next. That means this pointer is pointing to the next node. Then you have to display the information part of the second node. Let's run this program. Okay, so enter the information part of the node. First node, suppose information part is 12. Do you want to insert more node? Suppose I press Y. Enter the information part of the second node, 56. Suppose I press N. Sorry. For that, you have to write the AND operator. No OR operator. Enter the first node 23, Y, enter the information part, suppose 56, no. So the single linked list elements are, you see, so I have created two nodes. One is the first node, the information is 23. Second node, the information is 56. Okay, the single linked list elements are 23 and 56. Okay, in this way, you are going to create the nodes of the single linked list and display the elements of the single linked list. So all of you clear? Next class, I'll take how to display the elements of the single linked list. It will take around 5 minutes of time, but now it's 9:50. Okay.